So today we will see unit 3, quality assurance in fabrics and accessories. In that unit, first lesson should be on specification sheet for raw material and accessories. Now we will see that what is the meaning of a specification sheet in quality assurance, what is the significance of it, and what are the things covered in that specification sheet. Now, we will also see the importance of a specification sheet, how the source of generation of the specification sheet, and also we will see the basic elements of a specification sheets available. Now, specification sheet in a apparel industry or in a buying office is the heart of all this production. You see, buyer place any order to a company. So that company will take it forward by the use of this specification sheet. Now, today's environment, the manufacturing has become international. Buyers, they produce the goods taking different accessories, fabrics, trims from anywhere in the world. So it is totally a borderless manufacturing concept. So in such an environment, the communication to the factories are very, very important. How the goods or how the garment will be produced. Now, when retailers place orders, retailers give the design and quality specification, product specification of the product. Now, here the illustration is much more important than the text. So text message can be altered, or over a period of time going in different ways or different phases it may alter, but if it is in the form of illustration it will not be altered. So specification sheet is nothing but an illustration of what manufacturers will do as per the instruction of the retailer. Now first we will see what is a specification sheet and what does it contain. Now, specification sheet, basically it is a blueprint, and it is also called a tech pack or technical pack. Now, what are the things, major things are involved in the specification sheet is the construction details of the of a garment that will be there, then technical diagram or the blueprint of the garment should be there, or in other words, it is a sketch of the full garment should be there. Then third thing which will be there, that is the measurement point. So if we measure the garment, so what are the measurement points and what is the tolerance level in that measurement, that will be there in the specification sheet. So construction details is important there, technical diagram or the sketch of that particular garment is important, and also the measurement criteria is important in the specification sheet. So specification sheet is not only covering all the fabric details or the garment details or the blueprint, but also it is containing the packaging and labeling. So those parts also covered in the specification sheet. So this is truly a blueprint of a garment, starting from the manufacturing to the dispatch. And it is also the core lines of any style. So any style, if we want to incorporate, then particular that style should be first, sketching should be that done in that particular style, and that style is called the core lines or details of that particular styles. And these styles or core lines, whatever has been made into the particular blueprint or the sketch of the garment in the specification sheet, it is not a permanent one. So until and unless the production is completed, the people keep on changing or reviewing it and then upgrading it and make the amendment according to the requirement. Now how does it help to the manufacturers if such changes are there? Now the accuracy of doing this garment or the apparel when it is getting manufactured, that improves. Then the quality standard will improve. So buyer, they can send the correct samples based on the specification sheet. And finally, this all these details, if it is there, starting from the construction details, then the labeling, technical diagram, and also the measurement, all this together, it will help the manufacturer to calculate the cost of the garment effectively. And based on this, they can propose to the buyer the exact cost of the garment. So this is, in a nutshell, that what is the significance of this tech pack or the specification sheet. Now we will see the source of generation of the particular specification sheet or the spec sheet. So how this is getting generated, what are the ways or what are the steps involved, who generates this, those kind of things we'll cover in this source of generation of this specification sheet. Now number one is that buyer or designer is having the source of generation of the specification sheet, and they generate the specification sheet based on their own experience, and then they communicate to the factory. So this is the one way the specification sheet can be generated on the basis of the previous experience of the buyer or the retailer or the designer involved into that activity. Now, second point in the source of generation or second way is that buyer bought this particular style or a garment from a local stores, and then after bringing that one, they create the specification sheet in the particular garment. They create the specification sheet based on the whatever material available in the retail shops, and then during the buying trip, normally they carry it forward and they give it to the factory. And sometimes not only this local stores purchase, but also sometimes they use the own supplier specification sheet also. So there are two ways. Now you have seen a buyer or a supplier or the designers, they give the particular specification sheet to the factories, or they brought it from the market, and then during the buying trip they transfer it to the particular factory to do that. Now these are the two ways of sources of generation of the specification sheet. Now we'll see the third way, how it is getting generated. Now a particular factory, they are having, like in many other departments, like fabric inspection, then spreading, then sewing, then finishing. So they must have some sampling room. So while they generate the sample, along with that, they generate the specification sheet also. So this is the third source of generation of the specification sheet, that is the company's own sample room. Now there are many other ways also specification sheets can be generated. That is, one of the ways is the new variation from the existing styles. Suppose buyer has already done certain styles with a particular factory or a company. So buyer can bring little bit of variation in that style in the specification sheet and place the order. So this is the one way. And the another way is that using the existing specification sheet, an updation is also possible into that. So such kind of five different ways the source of generation can be possible. Number one is the buyer or designer can give this one to the factory, or they can brought it from different store and translate it to the factories and factory use that. Or third way of generation is the sample room of the factory or the company's own sample room. And fourth one is the new variation from the existing specification sheet, little bit of variations. And then fifth one is the existing specification sheet which is there, updation is also possible. So in this fashion, the specification sheet can be generated. So these are the five different sources of generation of specification sheet. Now we will see the elements of a specification sheet which are very important. What are the things will be there in the specification sheet? First we told about that there are three main things available into that. One is the construction details, technical diagram, and measurement. But now we will go into the detail of that elements of specification sheet. So number one of that is that all features of the style. Suppose a particular style one factory has to prepare or factory has to produce. So all the features of a particular styles should be there in the elements of the specification sheet. So number one of that is the buttoning. So what type of buttons that particular style they will use, quality of the buttons. So buttoning is the first one, that style. And then the second point is the pockets. What type of pockets actually will be there in that particular garment. Then third one is the different panels. So we have to stitch the panels. So what will be the panels? Okay, some description of the panels also should be given there. Then fourth one is the sleeve. So what are the sleeves will be used there? So those kind of sleeves, description of the sleeves or the details of the sleeves will be given in the style. Then the cuff, if any cuff is there in that particular garment, so what will be the style of that particular cuff? That will be there in the form of sketch in the specification sheet. Then the yokes, backside of the garment, that will be there. And then the last one is the collars. So the different types of collars can be used in a garment. So that what is the specification of the collar or how the collar will look like. So these are all part and parcel of a particular style of the garment. So all essential features of the particular style will be there in the specification sheet. So first point, we have covered that all features of the style that should be there in the specification sheet. Now second one, which is important here, that what are the things will be there in the embellishment or the in the design part of this garment. So now we have talked about the buttoning. Now what are the different types of button will be used in embellishment, quality or the what are the, whether it is a plastic button or is a wooden button. So different types of, or is a metal button. So all these things will be there in the embellishment part, embellishment that will be incorporated in the design. So number two is the stitching details. So in the garment, different type of stitching will be used. So those kind of stitching details will be there in the specification sheet. So number third category, which will be there in the particular embellishment part, is the zippers. So whether there is a metal zippers will be metallic zippers, zippers will be of which quality of the zippers will be used, the size of the zippers, then whether it is a metal zipper or plastic zipper. So all these essential elements of the zips will be there in that embellishment. So fourth one, which will be there, that description of the D-rings, if any D-rings is used. So what is the type of the D-rings, size of the D-rings, quality of the D-rings, those kind of things. Then toggles, if anything is to be used, that will be there in the specification sheet as an embellishment. Then prints, if there are any short the small prints in certain areas as an embellishment is there. So that description of the prints, what type of print it is, if it is a normal print, screen printing, that will be there, or it is a puff printing, that will be there, or is there any glitters are used in the printing. So such kind of things will be there in the print design part. And costing of the garment will depend upon what are the qualities of those kind of materials as an embellishment it has been used. So based on that, sometimes what happens, the buyers, based on the costing, so when factory proposes the cost of the garment based on all these accessories, so then they rework on it. The buyers sometimes rework on it to cut down the cost, or sometimes the factory gives like different risk assessment they do on that particular order, and they suggest to the particular buyer to amend it or to revise this certain part. So buyer do the necessary amendment in the specification sheet and they prepare the samples accordingly. So last part of this is the embellishment part, is the embroidery. So what type of embroidery will be used, what type of embroidery thread will be used there, so what will be the size of the embroidery, color in the embroidery. So all these things will be mentioned in the embellishment part that will be incorporated in the design. So we have seen the two types of elements so far in the specification sheet. Number one's the all features of the particular styles, and embellishment that has been used in a particular design, that is covered in the elements of the specification sheet. So third important part in the specification sheet we want to cover is that interior of the garment. So When we talk about the interior of the garment, we talk about the first of all the fabric, what is used in the garment, what type of fabric it is, if it is a synthetic fabric or it is a blended fabric, so fiber content of that particular blend that should be there in that particular garment. Then the construction details of the garment, what should be the what type of thread is used in the garment, then what will be the construction details of that thread, so such kind of things will be there. Then finish, what type of finish will be there. Nowadays different type of finish is applied on the garment, so whether pitch finish will be there or it is a mechanical finish, something should be applied on the garment. If any washing is there, what type of washing is to be done at what temperature. So all these things will be there in the garment description or the interior of a garment. Then in the finishing part, that will also come like a lining. If any lining is used in the garment, so what type of lining is to be used, whether there is a polyester lining or it is a cotton lining, what type of lining it is used. Then again here the garment stitching will come into the play, what type of stitching will be there in the garment. Then third part is the labels, different types of labels are used in the garment, so those kind of labels, how it is, what type of labels it is used in the garment. And also the pocketing, that interior pocketing, what will be the design of the pocketing, what will be the material used in the pocketing. So such kind of things will cover in the interior of the garment. So far we have covered the three different elements which are present in the specification sheet. Number one is the all features of that particular style of the garment, then embellishment incorporated in design, those kind of things what will be there in the garment in details. And third one, we have seen the interior of garment covering the construction, fabric, finish, etc. So fourth important point in the elements of the specification sheet what we are going to cover is the garment description or the garment information. So here the particular sketch of the garment, what will the garment, final look of the garment and different parts of the garment, how it looks like when assembled together. So the sketch of the garment will be given here. So number two in that particular category is the written description. So though the garment style and all these things are given here, but the written description of the garment, how the garment is getting prepared, what are the materials have been used in the garment. So little bit of description of the garment or name of the garment should be given here. Third important point in the garment description information is the embellishment. What are the different types of embellishment will be used here? Then one important fact of this garment description is the size range. What is the different size of the garment? So that will be used here, whether it is a M size or the S size or it will be used in the XL size. So different sizes of the garment that will be mentioned in the specification sheet. Then the entire color range, which are the colors? If it is a single solid color, it will be mentioned. If multiple colors are there, so all colors range should be used there and it will be described in that particular garment description. Next one is the fabrics, what type of fabrics will be used in the description. Then it comes the lining and interlining part of the garment, what type of garment interlining will be and will be used there and lining should be used there. And then special kind of stitching if it is applied, so that stitching details should be there. Then that specification sheet also should contain the style number of that particular garment for future identification. Then garment making instruction, how this garment will be produced, some instruction will be given. And last one is the labeling information, so different labels are used in the garment, like a care label is used, so where wash care instruction is given. So different type of labeling is done, what type of fiber content will be there in the label. So such kind of description, what is the country of origin of that particular production, so registration number, so all these things will be there in the garment description information in the elements of the specification sheet. So we have seen there are four different elements are present in the specification sheet. Number one is the all features of the different style, wherein starting from the pocket buttoning to the collars we have covered. Then second basic elements is the embellishment part of a particular design. Then third category of material, what we have seen is the interior of the garment, how it looks like, what are the material, what are the finish, what are the fabrics, what are the different construction parameters will be used there. And fourth one is the garment description information. So the sketch of the garment along with the total production details kind of thing, how it will be getting produced along with the labeling information, that will be there in the specification sheet. So we can now understand the specification sheet is so important, and in a particular sheet or the blueprint of that particular apparel, we can see all the basic elements of that garment, and the manufacturers can produce that and do the cost calculation easily. And it is not a very static one, it is a dynamic one, it keeps on changing while the production is running or when the sample is getting prepared. So buyer tends to change or amend or improve the particular specification sheet by doing the revisions, so that quality of the product will be improved, and also manufacturers can produce the quality as per the specification of that particular buyer, specification given by that buyer, so that buyer will be happy to see the product. So in the particular lesson, now we have seen the specification for raw material and accessories, and in that we have seen what is the importance, and in this kind of international manufacturing environment, how is the importance of the specification sheet, which is the way of translation in the way that instead of doing the text translation, buyers wants to give it in the illustration form, so that it will reach faster and presentation will be perfect. And we have seen the different important parameters of the details of this particular specification sheet, what are the things we'll cover there, what is the importance of it, how it helps the manufacturer in achieving the quality, and also how the better price can be obtained by doing the better drawing. Then we have seen the different sources of garment production, or different sources of the specification sheet generation, starting from the buyer's own activity to the factory's own sample room, and also the amendment of the existing one or the improvement of the existing specification sheet, that is also possible. Then we have seen the different four different elements of a specification sheet.